MLB The Show has baseball from the Lone Star State as we get a look inside Globe Life Field. Here it's the little guys on the big stage between the Durham Bulls and the Columbus Clippers. We've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. The batter will be Vidal Brujan, and we are set for baseball here this evening. The 1-1. It's the zone, a curveball in there for a strike. Weather shouldn't be much of a factor. 71 degrees here at game time. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Vidal Brujan goes down for the first out of the game. Fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. Digging in next, Josh Lowe. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Fastball called strike, 1-2. Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes. Working on striking out the side in the first. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away. Jim Haley would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Perfect. And we'll have the first base runner of the ball game here as that misses, and it's a two-out walk.
The first baseman, number 23, Jim Haley.
The 1-1 home.
Two balls, one strike.
Started to go around, but he's able to check his swing for ball three.
Three-two, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Another payoff pitch. Line towards center field. Oh, and he has some trouble with it.
Low
ignores his coach. He's chugging for home. The tag, and he is out. Now into the box, Gabriel Arias. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Let's get it going, boys. Somebody's loose, hitting 98 with ease in the first inning.
And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2. And now a pitch on the way.
Down to 3-2.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Line drive, fair ball down the line.
Batting second, no left here.
At the plate, Tyler Krieger fouled away. High in the air out to center field. Low will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Stepping in next, Nolan Jones. First chance for him here with a runner at first and one gone. Now the 3-2 pitch is swung on and missed. He got him. Two down with a runner at first, and the next to bat will be Josh Naylor. Pitch out, nothing doing. The 2-1 home. This is skied into short left center. Left fielder is on the move. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. Set for the start of the inning, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Grant Kaye. The 1-1. Soft liner to the left side. And one gone. Stepping up is Nick Schnell. No score here as we play inning number two. Breaking ball well inside and taken for ball three. Michael Brasso waits on deck. And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. So a runner at first with one out now. And that'll bring up Mike Brasso. One and one, here it is. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Hey, you know the pitcher right now, he's looking for that best friend, that double play ball. This is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
Ready now is Taylor Walls as he'll dig into the left-handed batter's box. Now the one and one pitch.
I got 2-1 to count.
And he lays off again, ball three. Joseph Odom would be next if they can keep this inning alive. Swung on, missed 3-2.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Ready to deliver the full count pitch. Count still full, 3-2. A payoff pitch one more time. Again, he sends it out of play. Schnell leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Lifted down the line in left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. Throw over to first, and the runner back safely. The 3-2 one more time. Lifted the other way down the left field line. And this hops over the wall out there for a ground rule double. And maybe a tough break as that'll freeze the runner at third with two gone. At the plate now, Joseph Odom. Now a curveball in there, 1-2 now.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. And a good throw is in time, and they escape the jam. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in the outfielder, Daniel Johnson. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Skied into straightaway right. Luplo is there and he makes the catch for the out. Now at the plate, George Valera. Two and one. Off speed pitch, good for strike two. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. Next will be the designated hitter, Ernie Clement, trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. 1-1.
Yeah, Matt, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down 1-2 in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times or do I have to sit on something else?
Two balls and two strikes now. High in the air out to center field. Low will get there and he puts it away to retire the side. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Vidal Brujan. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. This is swung on and popped up, crossing into foul territory now behind third. And there's the first out. Now it'll be Jordan Luplow. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. All even now. 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Count remains full. Bases are empty. One man out. Just hung in there on that one.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Jordan Luplow is out number two here in the third inning. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. Into the box, Jim Haley.
That's
3-1 now. Grant
Cade
would be next if they can keep this inning alive.
Full count.
And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Now the payoff pitch home. Holds off on the slider, and that's a good idea as it's ball four. So now here is Grant Cade. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, it's always a little frustrating when you square one up. You hit a solid line drive like he did it, and all you have to show for it is a jog back.
Meanwhile now, this is trouble down that right field line. This should be extra bases. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Now back, left field, Nick Schnell.
In now, Nick Schnell. Lifted down the line in left. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. And he takes ball four. So now at least they're set up for the force at any base here with two away. Mike Brosseau digging in at the plate. One of the bigger spots in the ball game so far. Base is juiced now with two away. This is on the ground to short. Is he going to get out of this? Over to first. He does get out of it, and the inning is over. Bottom of the third now, and next to hit is the catcher, Ryan LaVarnway. Now the 1-1 pitch. And a good throw gets him one gone. At the plate now is Aaron Bracho.
Aaron Bracho.
Now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Called strike two.
Boy, this guy's got it going on right now. He's executing everything. He should feel pretty good. He's retired 7 in a row.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out.
Now batting.
And now here is Gabriel Arias. 1-for-1 with a single so far.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
Now back, left
So now to the plate, Tyler Krieger, pulled toward right center field. Luplo is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring up the switch-hitting shortstop, Taylor Walls. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Line drive to left, and that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
Now back, the catcher, Joseph Odom.
Into the box now, Joseph Odom. 1-2 now.
1-2 down.
Got him on the good slider there, swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Now batting.
Now to the plate, Vidal Brujan, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Ready to deliver the 1-2.
That's in, ball two.
And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two. Next up, Jordan Luplo struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Inside, ball three.
Looks at a fastball inside, so he's in the driver's seat, 3-1. Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. He'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Leading off the inning, it'll be Nolan Jones as they'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2. Able to protect the plate with two strikes, and he'll see another one.
Gotta believe that was a mislocation because it missed right down the middle. This guy's gonna have nightmares at the plate thinking about missing that one.
Started the chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. So bases are empty with one gone, and the next to bat will be Josh Naylor. Now the 2-1.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
The 3-1 pitch. Grounded to short. And there are two away now. Now with the plate is Daniel Johnson. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far. The 3-2 pitch. Grounder down the line at third. And he fouls this one off. Another full count pitch home. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Daniel Espino, a 6'2" right-hander, jogs in to take over on the mound.
Number 34.
All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And next, it'll be the outfielder, Josh Lowe. Here comes the 1-2. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. Lavarnway corrals it, and throw down to first, one away. Next, it'll be Jim Haley. It was a walk in his last trip.
Haley.
The 1-1 takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
That's not really where you want to miss right there. I know this guy has got power stuff, but you can't live in the middle of the plate against this lineup and expect to have success.
And it's fouled away. One out, nobody on. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
The third baseman, number three.
Next, it'll be Grant Kaye. He doubled earlier in the game, one for two to this point. He goes with the slider that time, and it's driven to deep right field. Johnson retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and that'll bring up the outfielder, George Valera. On the run, this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down 1-2 now.
Hey, I can understand this batter's frustration right here. He's trying to be aggressive and get something going for his team. They're getting shut out in the fifth inning, but that's exactly why they're getting shut out. You need to keyhole and stay on the attack and make this pitcher come in the middle of the plate.
Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first down. Bases are empty, one man out. Inside corner called a strike 1-2. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. The pitch. Ryan LaVarnway will be next. Now the 3-2 pitch. Full count still. Fouled off. Donnie finally wears him down here as he strikes him out after a 9-pitch at bat.
Now
Ryan LaVarnway trying to avoid becoming the third strikeout victim of the inning here. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and it's full 3-2.
Hey, offense needs to check itself right here. They need to make this starter a little bit more uncomfortable. One strike away from 5 shutout innings.
Bruhan is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and digging in is the outfielder, Nick Schnell. Now the payoff pitch home. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. He'll try it again, 3-2. Tough pitch to lay off, but he did, and it's ball 4, so the leadoff hitter's aboard to start the sixth.
Now that.
So a runner at first now with nobody out, and that'll bring up Mike Brosseau. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
That's exactly the pitch you don't want to be chasing in these situations. He's going to keep that ball down below the hollow of the knee, try and get you to ground into a double play. You have to set your sights at least belt high.
Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Another payoff pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Center fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. So now into the box is Taylor Walls. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. Now a curveball is in there. 1-2 now.
Hey, I don't mind that take right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
So he chased out of the strike zone on that one. Taylor Walls sent packing for out number two in the sixth. Now the 1-1 pitch. Waves and misses for strike number two. To two balls and two strikes now. Schnell is off of first with two away. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. So stepping in is Aaron Braccio, struck out in his first at bat. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. Right side hit hard. And that is through into right field for a single.
The batter number 13. Shortstop.
Standing
Gabriel.
In now, Gabriel Arias.
Arias.
Fastball runs in tight here, and it's 2-1. Two and two.
That's a surprising late swing on a heater, middle cut right there. In a fastball count, he's going to have to turn it up a notch.
And this one gets away. And not what they were hoping for, as that moves the possible tying run into scoring position. Now the 3-2 pitch. Slow little roller to third. Fielded cleanly. Throw not in time, and he beats it out for his third hit tonight. At the plate, Tyler Krieger. And this is sliced hard down the left field line. And this will find the wall deep in the corner. One run scores. Here's a second runner around third. Tag is there, and he's out trying to score from first as the second run. Into the box, Nolan Jones. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. So a runner at second. Two down now. And the next to bat will be Josh Naylor. The 2-1 pitch. And this one's in the dirt. No advance here, but it's 3-1 now. Hits are even right now at five aside. Fouled away. Lifted in the air out to center field. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Into the box, Vidal Brujan. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Here's a comebacker back to the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out. Next, here is Jordan Luplo. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Here it comes on 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. He's fallen behind now. 3-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch, but if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. One and one count. Here's the pitch. Pulled hard, but it's foul down the first base side. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
The first baseman.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Jim Haley. He singled earlier, making him one for two to this point. No offer at the curve that time, and it's knotted up at two and two. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. Adam Conley will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 55, Adam.
Last half of the seventh here, and next to bat will be the outfielder, Daniel Johnson. The 1-1 home. Count is 1-2 now. Weak grounder down the line at third. Well, this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now the pitch.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
3-2 now. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Once again, a 3-2. Softly down the line toward first, but this will get foul, so again 3-2.
After that slider away, he must have set his sights out there, because he took that fastball in like he had no chance.
And he'll indeed make the play in foul territory for the first down.
Now
up next, George Valera. He's 0-2 in the ball game so far.
Valera.
Set. Here comes the 1-1.
Nope,
one out, nobody on. Two and two the count. Here's the pitch. High in the air down the right field line. Right fielder is on the run, and he makes the catch in the corner. Stepping in once again is Bernie Clement. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Fastball just inside. Hit the other way out toward right field. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Ready to begin the eighth, and set to go is the third baseman, Grant Cade. Hit out toward second. Reined in. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. So now to the plate, Nick Schnell. It was a walk in his last trip. Bases are empty, one man out. And this is swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number eight. So next to hit is Michael Brusso. Flew out last time up. Ball and two strikes now.
Unless you're willing to sell out and try and take one part of the field out of play and just work.
That will leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. Ryan Thompson is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 81. Ryan.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and now it'll be the catcher, Ryan LaVarnway. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. And he takes ball 3, so it's a full count now.
It's been a great job so far by the 8-hole hitter. If he finds a way to get on base, this could spell for a huge inning.
Hit down the third baseline. And there's a base hit. So just like that, the leadoff man's aboard, representing the potential go-ahead run.
Now batting, the second baseman, Aaron Brocco.
And now Aaron Brocco lifted the other way down the left field line. Left fielder giving chase. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Gabriel Arias. The 1-1 is a swinging strike on the slider.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball, you could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
Hit in the air down the right field line. Luplo back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone. Next to hit, Tyler Krieger. It was an RBI double for him in his last turn to the plate.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at bat will continue. And a pitch takes off inside and gets away, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The set and the 2-2, and he fouls this one off. Here's the 2-2. Okay. Full count now, 3-2.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Payoff pitch on its way. And he misses with it, ball 4, so the potential go-ahead run moves into scoring position now. And stepping in, Nolan Jones, and a big at-bat in this one. 2 on, 2 away here in the 8th. On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
Hey, don't kid yourself. I know those were two bad swings, but he hits middle of the order for a reason. It only takes one swing.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. And the 2-out threat won't pay off. The inning is over. All set to start the 9th in this one. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Taylor Walls. Fastball hit on the ground is short. He's right there. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the 9th inning gets underway. So the next to bat will be Joseph Odom, who's hitless in 3 at bats to this point. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now.
His heater's got some late ride through the zone. A lot of late swings right now. You're only going to get to that pitch if you get the front foot down early.
Another 1-2 delivery. Right side. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. Throw will not be in time at first. A good effort that time, but not enough to prevent them from getting a one-out base runner. Stepping in now, Vidal Brujan. And able to lay off the fastball away here. 2-1 now. And that's in there above the belt, so it's even now. 2-2.
He must know something we don't know. That was a center cut heater with count leverage in a big spot. I don't understand why he's taking it.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
Not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
High in the air out to center field. Center fielder giving chase. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So next to bat will be Jordan Luplow. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Ready with the 2-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Johnson gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. Ryan Sheriff comes on to work on the mound, hoping to send this one into extra innings.
Number 71.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And here comes the first baseman, Josh Naylor. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Luplow is there, and that is a big first out here to start inning number nine. Now at the plate here is Daniel Johnson. In his last at bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop-up foul.
Checked his swing there, and did he go? No, he did not, says the third base umpire. Ball two. Wanted to go after the slider, but he holds off. 3-1. George Valera will be next. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential winning run is aboard at first.
Center fielder.
Striding in is George Valera. Game on the line here, and a ball deep in the gap would make this place explode. Liner towards second. But this is hauled in by the second baseman. Striding forward now is the DH, Ernie Clement. He could make these fans go nuts and secure the win if he can place a ball deep enough into the gap. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Down. It could be extra bases. Here comes the winning run for the play. Now the relay home. And the winning run is across to score.
Endings just don't get much better than this. Great job at the plate putting the ball in play, and then the runner at first does the rest. Stop at third? No way. Rounded third, flew home, and scored the game winner. My heart is still in my throat.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. Columbus came through when it mattered in the ninth on the way to the win. Daniel Espino pitches well enough to get the W. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
the final line score for our ball game. For the victorious Clippers, 2 runs, 7 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Bulls, 1 run on 6 hits, no errors. They left 10 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 43 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.